President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. justifies government's move of offering a 10 million peso bounty for the arrest of fugitive televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. He also revealed why the sons of Chris Aquino visited the First Lady. Our very own Katrina Domingo now joins us with details. Kat, go ahead.
Hi, Carmina. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. justified the privately funded 10 million peso reward for the arrest of televangelist Apollo Quiboloy, saying that it is the fugitive pastor who needs to do some explaining to the public. He asks Quiboloy to actually show up before the public, before questioning the motives of these private citizens who donated some money to the government in order to fuel or quicken his arrest. The president says that he also questioned why Quiboloy and his camp kept on questioning the government's motives when, in fact, they are just following the rule of law. Let's listen to his statement.
Bakit hindi?
Bakit hindi government?
Bakit hindi? They want to help us bring a fugitive to justice. You know, he is a fugitive. He is hiding from the law. Now, if there are private citizens who want to assist the government in that effort to bring him to justice, I do not see what is any... So he can question their motives as much as they want. But magpakita siya. I question his motives. Let me question his motives. Bakit lagi kaming kine-question? Sinusundan lang namin ang batas. Sundin din niya ang batas.
Meantime, Carmina, the president also answered questions as to the nature of the visit of Joshua Aquino and Bimby Aquino Yap, who both were seen yesterday in First Lady Liza Araneta Marcos's office in Manila. The president says that the two Aquino scions visited the First Lady earlier this week to thank her for her help in their travel arrangements, noting that members of the two families, meaning the Aquino clan and its rival Marcos clan, have actually always been okay. He says that the reason why they went to the First Lady's office is simply to thank her after she extended some help for their travel arrangements. He describes the gesture as a very fine gesture on the part of the Aquino family, and that he says it puts a sort of more personal and a more human interaction between the two families who have both figured in the country's history, especially during the Marcos dictatorship and the EDSA People Power Revolution. Let's listen to the president's statement.
The reason na pinuntahan nila si First Lady ay simple lamang. Nangailangan si, I think it was Chris Aquino who needed some assistance for something. But what the reports did not say is that Lisa is their aunt. Dahil ang kanyang auntie ay napangasawa si Don Pepe na, the eldest brother of Cory. So they are related. Kaya hindi naman nakakapagtaka. It was just to help them for their travel, for their travel arrangements. So tumulong si First Lady at yun lang sabi lang papasalamat sila. I think it was a very fine gesture on the part of the Aquino family. I think it was it sort of, I suppose, put a little more personal, a human interaction between our families. We've always been okay. We just don't agree politically.
Meantime, Carmina, the president also attended and inspected the Upper Wawa Dam, which he described as the biggest water source to be built in the country in over 50 years, next to the Angat Dam. The president commended the private firms behind the project, saying that it was completed at a remarkable speed despite the pandemic. The president also underscored that the water supply from the Wawa Water Dam is expected to increase total supply around Metro Manila and nearby areas from 80 million today to 438 million liters per day once phase two of the project has been completed. The president expects its operations to begin by the end of 2025, which he says could, again, increase further the amount of water being produced to 710 million liters per day. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Katrina Domingo there joining us on the line. And six people, including a newlywed couple, confirmed dead after their vehicle was swept away by flash floods in Carmen, Cebu. Our very own Annie Perez now joins us with that story. Annie, what more can you tell us?
Yes, that's right, Carmina. Rescue responders found six bodies of the passengers on board a pickup that was carried away by the strong current in a creek in Sitio Mangitngit, Barangay Natimauan in Carmen, Cebu last Monday night. Carmen Mayor Carlo Villamor said that last night they were able to retrieve three more bodies. This included the newlywed couple and some teenagers. There were 17 passengers on board that pickup vehicle when they traversed a creek as heavy rains were occurring in Cebu that day. Initially, 10 were rescued and one was recovered dead that night. The following day, yesterday, they retrieved five more dead bodies. And now they are continuing their search and rescue operations for the remaining 15-year-old male. Mayor Villamor also clarified that the operations still remain to be for rescue since it has not been 3 days since the incident. Apart from the Municipality Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office, they already have rescuers from the Bureau of Fire Protection and other private organizations who are joining them in today's operations. As of this time, they are scouring the sea waters in front of the coastal barangays of Carmen Town. In his speech yesterday, President Bongbong Marcos Jr. also made mention of the incident and promised immediate aid to the affected individuals of the flash flood in Carmen. He instructed the Department of Social Welfare and Development to mobilize whatever help that they can give to the affected families, especially those who have lost their loved ones. The president also added that he and his offices are also on monitoring to the response of the incident. And that's the latest here in Cebu. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Annie Perez. They're joining us on the line. Over in Lanao del Sur, two children are missing after flood struck Balabagan in Lanao del Sur. Search and rescue operations are ongoing. Several towns along the coastal areas of the province are also affected by the floods. The rising waters also left motorists stranded along the Narciso Ramos Highway.